35 and new this morning, patching potholes, inspecting bridges, and fixing them after semi crashes.
That's right. Twice in the last month, large trucks have slammed into state bridges, closing them for emergency repairs. It happened at the Southwest 2nd on the I-40 crosstown. And Eyewitness News 5's Adam Slinger, you know, you saw the repairs there, didn't you?
Yeah, and as you guys both know, we've been checking to see what kind of problems and repairs bridges need, even more so now since the Minnesota bridge collapse. And we found out that one of the causes of emergency repair work is not the bridge necessarily deteriorating, but that some semi-trucks several times a year are crashing into our bridges.
You can see that's brand new concrete.
Part of the crosstown got a facelift to shore it up.
Essentially replace half of the deck in this section and that beam.
State Road Engineer David Streb says repeated run-ins with bridges like the crosstown have sped up the wear and tear on many of the state's ramps and bridges.
Sometimes they may not be aware of the height of their truck. It's not that uncommon that we have vehicle impacts with our bridges.
These pictures from the Department of Transportation show what's left of the Main Street Bridge over I-40 in Elk City.
That was probably one of the most substantial damages I've ever seen of a vehicle running off and hitting our structures.
Troopers say two people were killed when their tractor trailer slammed into these support pillars. Trucker Paul Azevedo says it's critical drivers know the height of their vehicle. If they don't, they're putting their life at risk and yours.
I've seen it all the time. The truck, it's pretty much total as far as the top of it.
As for that bridge hit hard in Elk City, ODOT thinks it will cost about $500,000 to fix it. They're hoping to have it reopened in just a few weeks. Back at the crosstown, Sophia, that ramp only cost about $150,000 to fix. Sophia.
And ODOT says they are trying to make the trucking company pay for the bridge repairs because cars do not normally cause the extreme damage.